Good morning, student. Myself Melissa Ankhla, and in today's session we continue with our subject design of precious concrete structure. And in this subject we start introduction session, and this one is the third lecture of our introduction and last lecture of introduction also. Then we will start our new chapter, that is losses in precious. Now the next topic is history of development of material. Okay, we already study the development of material. First we use bamboos, bricks, okay, and then we use steel, concrete, and then ultimately we use meanwhile time high strength concrete, high strength steel. That is the development of material. But here we study the history of development of material. That means in past we use which type of material and development of material. Okay, now first of all, reinforced concrete is combine of concrete and steel. Okay, in reinforced concrete we use two material, that is concrete and steel, and the combination of this material, both material resist the external forces that act on a structure. Okay, then plain precious concrete combine high strength concrete and high strength steel in active manner. Okay, in RCC steel and concrete is act as a passive manner, but in precious concrete high strength steel and high strength concrete will act as a active manner. Okay, in act as a active manner, that we already study in our first lecture. Okay, now this is achieved by how this activeness of this high strength steel and high strength concrete is achieved by tensing the steel. Okay, tensing the steel and holding it against the concrete, thus putting concrete into compression. Okay, how we achieve activeness of these two material? By tensioning the steel and activeness against concrete. Okay, resisting against concrete material, and thus we putting concrete into the compression. Because what happen ultimately when we tensioning the tendons and then after pouring the concrete, the total section of this precious concrete is under compressive forces. Okay, so here we put concrete into compression. Now the band and steps means strong poles, where both pre-stressed before there is subjected to any service load. That means this is a type of structure. Bands and strong poles when we use in pre-stress, first of all we pre-stress this structure before it is subjected to any service load or any external load, okay, or any design load. Okay, now in history of development of material, few patterns are registered in 1890, but these patterns are failed due to effect of shrinkage and creep. Okay, in past few patterns are registered for this precious concrete, but due to the effect of shrinkage and creep, the precious concrete is failed. It lost its strength after meanwhile time. Okay, now the next one, necessity of high grade of concrete and steel. Why we use high strength of steel and concrete in precious? Okay, now high strength of concrete has a higher bond strength in pre-tensioned concrete and high bearing strength in post-tension concrete. Here two type of strength. If we use high grade of concrete, okay, if we use high grade of concrete, it has a higher bonding in pre-tension. Okay, there are two type of pre-stress. First is pre-tension and second is post-tension. Okay, if we use high grade of concrete and steel, then this high grade of concrete induced more bonding, higher bonding in pre-tensioning. Okay, and higher bearing strength in post-tensioning. This concrete is produced higher bonding in pre-tensioning and higher bearing strength in post-tensioning. Okay, and creep and shrinkage losses are minimum with higher grade of concrete. It is very important. If we use higher grade of steel and concrete, the losses of shrinkage and creep is reduced. How it is reduced? That we learn in chapter number 2, losses of precious. Okay, simply you remember that when we use high grade of steel and concrete, the losses of shrinkage and creep is also meanwhile time reduces. Okay, now for pre-tensioning and post-tensioning, for pre-tensioning we use M30 grade of concrete, and for For pre-tensioning, we use M40 grade, and for post-tensioning, we use M30 grade. Okay, we say that for pre-tensioning M40 grade, M40 means 40 characteristic strength of concrete. Okay, FCK is equal to 40 Newton per mm square, and for post-tensioning we use M30. That means FCK is equal to 30 Newton per mm square. Okay, now the losses of precast member is varies. Generally, the range is given. Again, here the one must MCQ. The losses of prestress is varies 250 Newton per mm square to 400 Newton per mm square. Okay, this one is the losses that is occur during the age of prestress. Okay, and finally, if we use high strength steel and concrete, it varies from 1600 to 2000 Newton per mm square. Okay, if we use a high strength of steel and concrete, the losses will also increase, but compared to finally, the when our prestressed concrete is in final condition, the losses will be decreased. Okay, now again, this is a terminology of pre-tensioning and post-tensioning that we already studied. Pre-tensioning means method of pre-stressing in which tendons are stretched before and then concrete is pouring. Okay, after concrete hardening, we cut the tendons and stress is transferred to one material to another material. In post-tensioning, what happens? First of all, we pouring the concrete, and then after we stretch the tendons, and again stress is transferred from one material to another material. Okay, now next, advantage of pre-stress concrete. Okay, this is the most important theory of this introduction session. What is the advantage of pre-stress concrete? Okay, now first one, use of high strength concrete and high strength steel in pre-stress member, what happen? Result in lighter and slender the member. Okay, if we use, suppose I'm giving you example, if I use M10 grade, okay, then my section will be larger to resist. Suppose my load is equal to 500 Newton per mm square, and if I take M40 grade and my given load is equal to 500 Newton per mm square. Now guys, think that if I am providing M10 grade and if I am providing M40 grade, that means load strength of M40 grade is more compared to M10, so my section is become lighter compared to this one. Okay, that is the benefit of pre-stress concrete. Okay, because of high strength steel and concrete, our section is lighter and slender compared to our RCC member. Okay, now the next, in pre-stress member, it is free from tensile stresses. Because what happened when we study the concept of pre-tensioning, what happened at time? First of all, we provide the bed, and then stretch the tension, then pouring the concrete, then cut the tendons, and after that the stress of one material transfer to another. Okay, and in that condition, when tendons are regain its position, concrete are preventing them. Okay, concrete offer compressive force to tendons, and again steel tendons are trying to compress, that means decrease in length. Ultimately, the whole section of prestress subjected to compressive force, that means prestress member is free from tensile stresses. Now clear the concept how prestress member are free from the tensile stresses, because maximum number of forces are subjected to compressive forces. Okay, now prestress member dead load may be counterbalanced by eccentric pre-stressing. Okay, that means dead load means our service load or our design load. Okay, and this service load and this design load or dead load is counterbalanced by eccentric pre-stressing. That means in pre-stressing section, the section is pre-stressed by earlier compared to load is applied on the structure. Okay, in pre-stress member, our section is loaded before, that means our section is apply load before when external load is apply on the structure. Okay, so that this dead load is design load is counterbalanced by this eccentric pre-stressing. Okay, now the fourth one, pre-stressing concrete member possess better resistance to shear force effect of compressive stress. Okay, again, total pre-stress section is subjected to compressive force, so that due to this compressive force, our pre-stressing member is better give resistance to shear forces. Okay, now use of high strength concrete, due to this our pre-stressed concrete member is free from cracks. Okay, and also its durable capacity is increased, okay, due to high strength of steel and concrete. Cracking of our surface is removed in pre-stressed concrete, and durability of concrete is also increased. Then long span structure is possible. Okay, here the long span just like our bridge, long span structure is possible to construct, and weight is significant losses. Okay, weight is significantly minimized in pre-stressed concrete member, because here we use a high strength of concrete and steel, so section is also reduced. If section is also reduced, then our weight of section is reduced. Okay, now in this type of pre-stressed concrete member, factory production are possible. If you want to construct a mass production, okay, then it is possible in pre-stressed concrete member. And pre-tensioning concrete is the type of this type of production. Okay, then pre-stressed member is tested before use. Okay, it is very important. Okay, strength of pre-stressed concrete member we already know before application, because we measure the strength of pre-stressed member. Now pre-stressed concrete structure deflect less compared to RCC member. Okay, deflection of pre-stressed concrete member is lesser than our RCC member, and pre-stressed concrete structure deflect appreciably before ultimate failure, and it is give a more time for before collapsing. That means pre-stressed concrete member deflect less, and it is ultimately failure. It give a time when it is fail, and due to this we have a maximum time for surviving. Okay, and last, fatigue strength of pre-stressed concrete member is better than our RCC. Okay, fatigue means resisting load carrying capacity of our pre-stressing member is more than our RCC members. Okay, now it is not possible each and everything has only and only advantage. There are some disadvantages also. Okay, and the disadvantages of this pre-stressed concrete is, first, for pre-stressed concrete, experienced builders is required. For pre-stressed concrete, experienced engineers is required. And equipment cost for pre-stressing is very high. Okay, here skilled labor is required, skilled builder is required, skilled engineer is required, and the equipment cost for this pre-stressing is also very high. Then ultimate, pre-stressed section is brittle. Why? In pre-stressed concrete member, the maximum number of forces is subjected, that is compressive forces. Okay, and compressive means concrete is subjected to compressive force. Maximum number of forces are compressive force, and nature of concrete is brittle. Okay, if there is a steel, then it is ductile. But if it is made up of total concrete and compressive force are maximum, then tensile forces, what will happen? This pre-stressed section is act like a brittle material. Okay, and pre-stressed concrete section is less fire resistant. Okay, fire resisting capacity of pre-stress is less compared to our RCC structure. That is the disadvantages of pre-stressed concrete. First one is experienced builder required, experienced labor required, okay, skilled labor required. Then cost is very high of this pre-stressed concrete for construction. Okay, pre-stressed concrete section is brittle. Okay, and lastly, less fire resisting capacity of this pre-stressed concrete members. Okay, now difference between pre-stressed concrete over reinforced concrete. Now we compare this pre-stressed concrete with reinforced concrete. Okay, pre-stressed concrete over reinforced concrete. Now first one is, in pre-stressed concrete member, the major role of steel, major role play the material is, that is steel, because here steel is play in active manner. That means active manner means stress in steel is developed before external load is applied. Clear? Active role means stress in steel is developed before when external load is applied. Okay, because here we apply tension force, stretching force in steel before our pre-stressing member subjected to design load or external load. In just opposite in RCC member, what happened? In RCC member, steel play a passive role, because steel in RCC member depend upon the external load. ओके सपोज योर आई ड्रॉ अ वन बीम, ओके सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम, दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आरसीसी. दिस बीम इज एक्टिव वेन इट इज सब्जेक्टेड टू डिजाइन लोड एंड देन आफ्टर इट इज रिफ्लेक्ट. ओके बट इन प्री स्ट्रेस इट इज बिफोर एप्लीकेशन ऑफ लोड और स्टील मेंबर आर स्ट्रेच्ड, दैट मीन्स इट सब्जेक्टेड टू स्ट्रेसेस. ओके दैट मीन्स इट इज इन एक्टिव रोल. एंड इन आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर अवर स्टील इज सब्जेक्टेड टू पैसिव रोल. क्लियर? ओके नो एक्सटर्नल लोड नो स्ट्रेस इन स्टील फॉर आरसीसी. इफ देर इज नो एक्सटर्नल लोड देर इज नो स्ट्रेस इन स्टील. ओके नाउ द सेकेंड प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट स्ट्रेसेस इन स्टील ऑलमोस्ट कॉन्स्टेंट. ओके इन प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग द स्ट्रेसेस इन स्टील इज कॉन्स्टेंट थ्रू आउट द स्पान बिकॉज इट इज इक्वली सब्जेक्टेड टू टेंसाइल फोर्सेस. इट इज इक्वली सब्जेक्टेड टू टेंसाइल फोर्सेस बट जस्ट ऑपोजिट इन आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर. इन आरसीसी स्ट्रक्चर स्ट्रेस इज वेरिएबल विथ लीवर आर्म. ओके बिकॉज अवर सेक्शन इज लाइक दिस वे. ओके तो अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर लीवर आर्म आरसीसी स्ट्रेसेस इन स्टील इज वेरिएबल विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू अवर स्ट्रेस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन डायग्राम ऑफ बेंडिंग स्ट्रेस एंड शियर स्ट्रेस. ओके नाउ प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट इज मोर शियर रेजिस्टेंस compared to RCC because in prestress concrete member total overall section is subjected to maximum number of compressive forces so that shear resisting capacity of prestress concrete member is higher than our RCC member because in RCC both steel and concrete both are equally resist the tensile force and compressive force. Okay so shear resisting capacity of RCC will be variable. Now प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर डिफ्लेक्शन इज लेस कंपेयर टू आरसीसी बिकॉज वट हैपन इन प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर डिफ्लेक्शन इज लाइक अपर. ओके दैट आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू टू टू थ्री टाइम्स. ओके द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर इज अपवर्ड एंड द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ आरसीसी मेंबर इज डाउनवर्ड. ओके बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अपवर्ड डिफ्लेक्शन इज लेसर कंपेयर टू डाउनवर्ड डिफ्लेक्शन. ओके सो दैट प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर डिफ्लेक्शन इज लेस बिकॉज एसेंट्रिक प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग फोर्स प्रोड्यूस इज कपल. ओके हियर दिस फोर्सेस आर प्रोड्यूसिंग कपल एंड दिस इज काउंटर बैलेंस बाय दिस डिफ्लेक्शन. ओके एंड डिफ्लेक्शन अल्टीमेटली यू रिमेंबर दैट डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट इज लेसर देन आरसीसी मेंबर्स. ओके नाउ द नेक्स्ट वन नेक्स्ट फिफ्थ नंबर व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट अवर अवर रेनफोर्समेंट रेनफोर्स्ड कॉन्क्रीट. ओके प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट फैटिक रेजिस्टेंस इज मोर कंपेयर टू आरसीसी बिकॉज आरसीसी द स्टील इज डिपेंड अपॉन एक्सटर्नल लोड. ओके एंड इन प्लेन सीमेंट सॉरी प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एक्सटर्नल लोड. ओके दैट मीन्स द फैटिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ प्रीस्ट्रेस मेंबर इज हायर देन ऑफ आरसीसी मेंबर बिकॉज आरसीसी मेंबर इज डिपेंड अपॉन एक्सटर्नल लोड एंड अवर प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एक्सटर्नल लोड बिकॉज इंटरनल मेंबर्स इंटरनल टेंडन्स आर ऑलरेडी अप्लाई स्ट्रेस बिफोर डिजाइन लोड अप्लाई ऑन स्ट्रक्चर एंड प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर इज मोर ड्यूरेबल देन RCC because in prestress concrete we use higher strength of steel and concrete that's why the durability of prestress concrete is higher than reinforced cement concrete. Okay now the last one is prestress concrete dimension is less but obvious if we use higher strength of steel and concrete the dimension of prestress member are less compared to our RCC member. Okay that I'm already giving you the example of M10 and M30. Okay if grade of steel and concrete are higher then ultimately our dimension of section is decreases. Okay and ultimately we save the material. Okay this is the benefit of prestress concrete member. Okay prestress concrete member are most important for use of mass production. Okay now the last topic comparative between pre-tension and post-tension. Okay here we compare what is the difference between pre-tensioning member and post-tensioning member. Ultimately pre-tensioning and post-tensioning is the method of pre-stressing concrete. There are two methods of pre-stressing. First is pre-tensioning and second is post-tensioning. Now we discuss what will happen in pretension and what will happen in posttension. That we already studied, but now simply we differentiate it. Okay, now first, in pretensioning, now you all of you remember that in pretensioning, first of all, the tendon bars are stretched, then concrete is poured into it, and then when concrete is hardened, we cut the tendons, and stress are transferred by tendons, by strands, by cable to means of bonding. Here the main criteria is pretensioning is bonding between concrete and steel. Okay, just opposite in post tensioning, concrete is done first. Okay, here concreting is done first, and then wires, cables, strand, tendons are tensioned and anchored at the end, and the stress is transferred by end bearing, not by bonding. Okay, here last end is subjected to jacketing. Okay, and the stress is transferred by this end bearing, and in this case stress is transferred by bonding between steel and concrete. Okay, here two differentiation: first tendon stress, concrete. Okay, then tendon cut, and stress is transferred by bonding from one material to another material. And in post tensioning, reverse process, here the stress is transferred by end bearing, okay, not by bonding. Now second, here this pretensioning member are suitable for shorter span. Okay, and mass production like sleepers, then railway sleepers, then electric poles are suitable for this pretensioning member. Okay, shorter span, if you want to make a structure of shorter span, we use pretensioning member method. And if you want to construct a longer span, just like bridges, then we use this post tensioning method. Okay, for mass production and shorter span like electric poles, then sleepers, we use pretensioning, and for mass for longer span like bridges, we use a post tensioning method. Okay, now pre-stress, this pre-tensioning method subjected to higher losses compared to this post-tensioning. Okay, because it is subjected to creep and shrinkage. Here the maximum failure is creep and shrinkage, which will be affect after a long time. But maximum failure of pre-tensioning is higher than post-tensioning, and losses is compared to less in post-tensioning. The maximum loss of this post-tensioning is friction, due to friction. Okay, that we deeply discuss in chapter number 2. Okay, just you remember that losses in pre-tensioning is lesser compared to post-tensioning, and losses of post-tensioning is lesser than pre-tensioning. Okay, in pre-tensioning losses is higher than post-tensioning, and post-tensioning what will happen, losses is less. Now the last one, okay, last comparison. In last comparison, we discuss about cable alignment. Okay, in pre-tensioning, what happened? In first figure, we already studied. Okay, in pre-tensioning, what happened? The tendon bands are stretched. Okay, elongated or in tension. We apply tension forces in tendon bars. Okay, the here this cable is in straight condition. Okay, straight and horizontal. And placing them in curved or inclined position, it is difficult, because the main criteria of this pre-tensioning member is that we put this cable in straight condition, horizontal condition. We can't place this cable and this tendons in curved condition. So when we plot a bending moment diagram for this, okay, it is not possible according to this cable. Okay, ultimately our diagram will be zero for that. So that structural and advantages with respect to this pre-tensioning are lesser compared to this post-tensioning. Just opposite in post-tension, what happened? First of all, concreting, and here the cable are provided. Okay, in cable is provided in a duct. Okay, then concreting, after concreting hard, we stretch this cable. Okay, so that means our cable are provided here in curved surface, incline. Okay, cable is provided in incline. So here advantage, economical advantage of this post tensioning member according to cable is more compared to this pre tensioning cable. Okay, now limitation of Pre-stressing, that means same disadvantages. Okay, what is the disadvantages of pre-stress concrete? That is the limitation of same heading. Okay, content is same. Limitation of pre-stress. First one is skill technology is required, then skill labor is required, then high strength of material is used and it is very costly, then equipment is used, again it is very costly. Okay, and it need a quality control and inspection. Okay, high strength material required, so cost is increased, then equipment required, again cost is increased, then quality control and inspection is required for this type of technique. Okay, then skilled labor required, experience builder required. Okay, there are so many drawback also. Okay, then that means overall cost of our pre-stressing is sometimes also increased. Okay, now okay, this one is the most important thing. How the load mechanism of reinforced cement, reinforced structure, reinforced concrete and pre-stressed concrete. Okay, this one is the first figure. Suppose I am here, I draw one figure of simply supported beam. It is subjected to dead load. What happened? This is the figure. After subjected to external load, design load, beam is deflected like this way, and this is our cantilever beam, and it is deflected by it, free end is deflected and deflection like this way. Okay, this one is compression, this one is tension, and here this is tension and inner portion is compression. Clear? Now pre-stressed concrete before loading. This is the condition of pre-stressed concrete before loading. That means external load is applied before this pre-stressed member. In first figure, we already studied that beam is casted on bed, and here stretch tendons are stretched. Then after pouring the concrete, we cut the tendons. What happened? Tendons are tried to decrease its length, regain its original position. Okay, that means decrease in length, and concrete is prevent. Concrete is resist this change in dimension of steel. Okay, counterbalance this. Ultimately, after this figure, our pre-stressed concrete section is deformed like this way. This is the before loading condition, and cantilever is deflect like this way. Okay, and then after our pre-stressed concrete member is subjected to design load. Okay, this is our design load after construction, design load, or we can say service load. Okay, this is our design load, service load. And what happened when it is subjected to service load, external load, this member will be act like this way. That is the benefit of pre-stressed concrete member, because ultimately it is already stressed in its construction. Okay, this member is already subjected to internal stresses at the time of construction, and then after it is subjected to service load also. So it will counterbalance, and in opposite of RCC, the structure is subjected to load at a time of construction. Okay,